Do you ever wonder what it was like to go to the dentist over 100 years ago? You may be horrified to find out. I'm Liza Schade, and this is your local peek at the past. This artifact may look like an old torture device, but it's actually an 1870s foot-powered dental drill. It's 58 inches tall and composed of black lacquered cast iron, and it has a spring-loaded foot pedal that still works. The drill stand was made and sold by Samuel Stockton White, who started his dental manufacturing business in 1844 in Pennsylvania, making porcelain teeth. In the 19th century, most folks went to a local blacksmith or a local barber surgeon when they had a toothache. These strong men, they focused on ripping out bad teeth with pliers and used no medication, except maybe a shot or two of good whiskey. If they were lucky, the dentist might have had ether on hand to put them out a bit. This particular drill was used from 1890s to the 1920s at the practice of Dr. Robert Nixon, who set up shop in Forest Grove right on Main Street. Both his son, Robert Nixon II, and his grandson, Robert Nixon III, followed in his footsteps, and they all practiced in the same office. The pace of the drill all depended on how fast Dr. Nixon could pump his foot. So next time you get your teeth checked, remember how lucky you are to have today's super fast drills and a dentist trained to do it right. Coming up on Peek at the Past. Is this a witch's cauldron or something just a little less sinister?